Hey, what's up guys, it's Tips, and welcome to my Classic WoW Engineering Guide. In this video, I'll be teaching you how to level your engineering profession from 1 to 300 in a quick and efficient manner. Let's get started. Below are the required materials you'll need to reach 300 engineering. You can purchase these materials from the auction house or acquire them out in the world while leveling. Once you've acquired the mats needed, you'll be ready to begin. Level 1 to 75, Apprentice Engineer. Before you can start leveling your profession, you'll have to acquire the Apprentice Engineer skill from an engineering trainer. These trainers are available in any one of the faction capitals. Purchase the skill and begin by crafting 60 rough blasting powders using your 60 rough stones. This should get you to around level 36. At level 36, you'll be crafting 30 handful of copper bolts by using 30 copper bars. This should take you to at least level 55. Make sure to have a blacksmith hammer in your inventory and be near an anvil while you're crafting. At level 55, return to your trainer to learn journeyman engineering and your new recipes. You'll be making an arc light spanner next. This requires 6 copper bars and should remain in your inventory for the duration of your leveling. It will also grant you one skill. From 56 to 75, you'll be crafting rough copper bombs. You'll need 30 copper bars, 30 linen, and the 30 copper bolts and 60 rough blasting powder you just made. This should easily take you to level 75, if not higher. Level 75 to 150, Journeyman Engineer. At this point, you'll most likely be around 75 to 80 engineering. Craft 40 coarse blasting powders using 40 coarse stones to get you to level 95. From 95 to 100, you'll want to make coarse dynamites. This recipe will probably be yellow or green for you, so you want to make around 10 to reach level 100. You'll need 30 coarse blasting powder, which you've just made, alongside 10 linen cloth. From 100 to 110, you'll want to make 10 silver contacts. 10 silver bars are required. At 110 to 125, you'll be making bronze tubes. I've gotten to 125 by making just 16 of them, but you'll likely need more than that. Make 20 tubes just in case, which will require 40 bronze bars and 20 weak flux, purchasable at the engineering vendor. From 125 to 141, you have a few options. If moss agate is cheap on your server, you can purchase 10 of those to make 10 standard scopes. This will also consume 10 of your bronze tubes that you just made and take you to level 135. From there, make 30 heavy blasting powder using 30 heavy stones to reach 141. However, if moss agate is not an option for you, make 60 heavy blasting powders instead, meaning an additional 30 heavy stones will be required. Both routes should get you to 141. At 141, you'll want to make Wearing Bronze Gizmos. 15 of them should take you to level 150. You'll need 30 bronze bars and 15 wool cloth for this. Once you've finished crafting the gizmos, you will need to upgrade your engineering skill again. Instead of visiting a typical engineering trainer, Alliance players will have to find Spring Spittle Fizzle gear in Ironforge, and Horde players will have to go to Roxic in Orgrimmar in the Valley of Honor. Purchase expert engineering from these NPCs to raise your cap to 225. 150 to 225, Expert Engineering. From 150 to 160, you'll be making 15 bronze frameworks. They require 30 bronze bars, 15 medium leather, and 15 wool cloth to make. If by chance you don't hit 160 with just the frameworks, purchase 2-3 gold bars and create 2-3 gold power cores. From 160 to 175, you'll be making explosive sheep. This requires 30 heavy blasting powder, 15 wearing gizmos, 15 bronze frameworks, and 30 wool cloth. Luckily, you just made most of these. From 175 to 176, you'll need to make one gyromatic micro-adjuster. This recipe requires 4 steel bars. Once you've made the adjuster, keep it in your inventory as you'll need it later. From 176 to 195, you'll be making 60 solid blasting powder. This requires 120 solid stone. Save the blasting powder because you'll need it later. Mithril tubes are up next. To reach 200 from 195, you need to make 7 of these tubes. 21 mithril bars will be required. Once you reach level 200, you'll be given the option to specialize in either gnomish or goblin engineering. I'll talk more about the pros and cons of each of these in a later video, so don't worry about that right now. All you need to worry about is skilling up. From 200 to 215, you'll be making 20 unstable triggers. 20 mithril bars, 20 mage weave cloth, and 20 solid blasting powder are required. Hang on to the triggers when you're finished. From 215 to 237, you'll be making mithril casings. You need to make about 40 of these to reach 237, so have 135 mithril bars ready in case you come up short. When you reach 225 engineering, make sure you visit Buzzik Bracket Swing and Gadget Zan to train artisan engineering and raise your cap to 300. After that, continue making the casings until you reach 237. 225 to 300, artisan engineering. From 237 to 250, you'll be making 20 high explosive bombs. They require the 40 solid blasting powder, 40 mithril casings, and 40 unstable triggers that you've already made. From 250 to 260, you'll be making 27 dense blasting powder. This requires 54 dense stones. From 260 to 283, you'll be making 25 thorium widgets. They require 75 thorium bars and 25 rune cloth. And for the last step, you'll be making thorium tubes from 283 to 300. The schematic for these tubes is purchased from Zizzer Fizzbolt in Winterspring. He's located in a building just inside Everlook. Once you have the schematic, all you will need is thorium bars. About 120 will suffice, but you may need a few more depending on RNG. Use the bars to craft the thorium tubes from 283 to 300, and you should be capped. Now go out there and make some cool gadgets. Or not. But thanks for watching the video, guys. If you're looking for more guides to aid you on your classic journey, sub it up and stick around, because we got more coming. A quick shout out to all my patrons who make videos like this possible. If you'd like to become a patron and support the channel as well, I've left the link in the description for you. And for more classic WoW and vanilla content, you can check me out live on Twitch at twitch.tv/tipsoutbaby. Have a wonderful day, fellas. See you guys on Twitch, and as always, tips out, baby.